राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम
जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
ओम मूर्ति पे आना सुन
ओम निष्प्रपञ्चाय शान्ताय निरालम्बाय तेजसे ॐ यस्यात्मभूतस्य गुरुप्रसादात् अहं विमुक्तोऽस्मि संसारबन्धात् सर्वोपजन्तु शिवानन्दमूर्ते मृदाग्नियुक्तं प्रणतोऽस्मि नित्यं व्यासन्तुं दीनबन्धुं शास्त्रार्थबोधनपटुं मस्केन्द्रवरं नौमि श्रीचिदानन्दसद्गुरुम् ॐ प्राणिनां दुःखहर्तारौ ज्ञानदो भुवनमुक्तये शिवानन्द चिदानन्दो आश्रये गुरुसत्तमो ॐ शान्तात्मानं प्रणतसुलभं सिद्धविद्याप्रभावं बास्वद्रूपं सुगुणनिलयं दुष्टकर्मादिवर्गं प्रज्ञावृत्तं निजसमदृशं ताजलं त्यागीभज्यं साक्षात् ईशं मम गुरुपदम् शिवानन्दं नतोऽस्मि शिवानन्दं नतोऽस्मि अखण्डानन्दसम्बोधो वन्दनात्यस्य जायते गोविन्दं तमनुं वन्दे चिदानन्दतनुं गुरुं चिदानन्दतनुं गुरुं ॐ मै प्रणाम्स् The holy persons of Pujya Papa, Pujya Mataji and Pujya Swami and the persons of the Supreme Reality in every one of you here. We are very happy to be part of this centenary celebration of Papa, Sanyas Diksha Day. Papa's sannyas is not an ordinary sannyas. There are two types of sannyas. Normally the sannyas diksha given, that is called vividisha sannyas. Vividisha sannyas means those who want to realize, those who are self in search of God, those who want to realize God. They have to practice certain things, they have to follow certain rules, course of conduct, and they have to work for that. They have to do the sadhana for that. Vividisha means vetu vichcha vividisha. The desire to know the presence of God. That is vividisha sannya. That is the normal sannya. The other is vidvat sannya. Those who already realized it. And then they take the sannyas. They experience that. So Papa's sannyas is like that. Because Papa, when he took the sannyas, he has taken the vows. There is nothing other than Ram here. Everything is Ram for him. So he was very much aware of the all-pervading nature of God, and he has submitted to that. It was not an intellectual perception or intellectual understanding. It was not an information for him. It was something real, and he lived up to it. So that was Papa Sanyas. Papa Sanyas is a people have to envy at his sanyas. That sanyas is not, it's not everybody's gift. Very few had such experience. So the Shastras declare the Supreme Reality in two ways. There is nothing other than that is here. That alone exists. Nothing other than that exists. That is one. The other is everything is there. Leha nanasti kinchana. There is nothing other than that. The nanatva is not there. That alone is here. That is one. The other thing, whatever you see here, everything is that one. Sarvam khandidam brahma. Both are the two sides of the same coin, the upwards and the reverse side. Told in different ways. to experience there is nothing is here is as good as experiencing that everything is that. But it is told in different way. But when you say that there is nothing other than that is here, then there is no question of speaking. You can't explain that actually. But everything is here means it is perceptible actually. Whatever you see here, you behold God in everything you see. So that is the practical aspect of realization. So those who are realized to say they are interacting here, they live here, they have to necessarily interact with things here. They want to, as long as we have got a body, we will be meeting certain things here. We have to live here, we have to interact with the things around us. So the presence of God has to be felt in that. So that is at the level of experience. So our Shastra speaks about it in different ways. So I will touch upon those things later. Today morning I came here. I have no idea how. I just came here and then Swamiji told me that is Ayodhya one is there. We will go and see that. So a lot of plants are there. Different plants. So that means informative. And when children come, they see me. And then they understand the utility of these things. And then they get to know more about those things. They get involved in that. So these are part of our ancient civilization. Of course, we say it now in new words. We use it. New terminologies to explain it. But all these things are already mentioned in our Shastras. Right from the Vedas to the Puranas and the Itihasas, etc. Some of those points I would like to share with you. And these things are relevant when we consider Papa's sannyas also. To behold everything as God, to behold everything as God, to see His presence everywhere. So that is the subject, which is the only subject dealt with in our Shastra. So the primary scripture is Veda. And the Veda, the Rigveda is considered to be the oldest. And it is maybe more than, we do not know the time, so even the Western scholars accepted it as 2000 years before, 5000 years minimum. So the first mantra of the Rigveda is Agnimele Purohitam Nityasya Deva Mrityujam. So it starts with the first word Agni. Because the Vedas handle this Yajna, Yaga, etc. They worship the Supreme Reality in the form of Agni. Agni is considered as the first manifestation, the visible God. They are all made of five elements, the Panchabhuta. Whatever we see here, all are Panchabhutika, made of five elements. So the first one is space. Space we cannot see. Then air. Air you can little feel, but that's also you cannot see that. What is perceptible is Agni, space, air, Agni, then water and earth. Water and air. So Agni is the first perceptible thing. all these things are made of Agni. There is nothing without the fire element involved in that. Everything here we see, everything we behold, is Pancha Bhutika Vastu. And so the presence of Agni is there in everything. So to feel the presence of God everywhere, they say what is perceptible through that, they say. So all things we hear, we see here, we behold here, they are made of these five elements only. Those things which are not made of five elements, we cannot understand. Everything is made of five elements only. So Agni is the first element, the presence of which is there in everything. Everything has got a temperature, otherwise it cannot exist. Temperature can be minus also, okay. Then everything is made of water also. Apova idagum sarvam. Everything is water here. Our body contains 80% of water. So the first perceptible element is Agni. So Agni Vinila, it starts like that. So Agni is worshipped. Agni is worshipped as the supreme reality. Agni is Bhagavan. Later on they give different interpretations. Agni Mukhabai Deva. All the devatas are worshipped. So even when we want to worship Bhagavan, we have to be light a lamp. Why should we light a lamp? The very Vaidika, the Vaidika Sampradaya, the very way of worship. The worship is either in water or in Agni or on the earth. So usually all the yajnas are done in fire. Otherwise it is done on water. Or on the earth. So Pinirmukhavi Devaha. So in order to make Agni, not to do a karma, they need a fire, and to have the fire, they need this some material which can produce fire, which can retain that fire. That is next Yajurveda mantra: Ishetva Urjetva Vayavatta Upayavatta Devovatta Vita Prapayadu Shrettatama Yakarmane. So Ishetva means actually it speaks about the summit. Malayalam they call it Chamada, the fuel, the firewood. The firewood, because you put the fire, you burn the firewood and produce Agni. And also, those days, they used to make fire by rubbing the two wood, Arani in the colleges, they churn the wood and then produce fire. And the Samayana mantra is also Agni only. Agnaya hi vitaye gnanu hapyata deye nihoda sakti garhiji. So they are also Agni. And in the Atharva Veda, it's very interesting thing, Atharva Veda mantra. Channo Devi Abhitaye, Apo Bhavantu Bhitaye, Apo Bhavantu Bhitaye, Akumit Mata. Channo Devi Abhitaye, let all of us be comfortable here. Let all of us be safe and happy here. Let the waters be potable, suitable for drinking. Let all the water be pure here. Apo Bhavantu Bhitaye. So that the water be potable. Potable means suitable for drinking purpose. It can be consumed. So it speaks about the water. So they worship Bhagavan. So the Vigrahadana Sampradaya, the worship in the temples and the worship of God's Vigraha are introduced later. Initially, the worship was in fire, water and water. But now also, for functions like this Satyapta Murti or anything, they do Varana Japa and water they do the Japa. And that water will be poured out. Even Bhagavan also, Kalisa, this one, in that water they invoke everything and then that water is used for Abhishek of Bhagavan. And for our purification also, then water is used. So, and when you go into the Vedas, later on we find that there is a lot of mention about the plants. We are all Bhagavan Srishti and we consider we are superior. So all these animals are also Bhagavan Srishti only. Bhagavan, we have not created the animals. So Bhagavan has not created human animals. He has created the animals, he has created the plants. So everything is his creation. And from one angle, we are all equal actually. Bhagavan Swarupa only, you are Bhagavan Swarupa, you are divine. You are divine. Ram Brahmasmi, they say. Likewise, these trees and plants, all these things are also divine. They are also divine. The animals are also divine only. That is why there are worship of, we worship cows, we worship elephants, we worship Tulsi, we worship the Bilva tree and the gooseberry tree. Trees are worshipped here, the plants are worshipped here, the mountain is worshipped here, the rivers are worshipped here. Ganga, we worship, Yamuna, we worship. Kaveri Vyoshi, Himalaya Vyoshi. So, all creations, Bhagavan's creations, they are also equally God only. Bhagavan has not created something outside him. He himself has become all these things. Let me become many, that was his concept. Bhagavan conceived the first. A sankalpa came in his mind, let me become many. So he became many. He only that one, only has become many. So to behold that one in everything here is actually the highest form of worship. Highest form of worship. So I was mentioning about these plants, so I will come to that plant. So in the Vedas, I said, it speaks about this. The Yajurveda mantra starts with this samik. And in the Rigveda also, there are number of mantras on plants. One is, many of you may be knowing, that in all our rituals, suppose it is Upanayana or Chauna or Vivaha, whichever samskara we give, these are samskaras actually. When these rituals or samskaras are being done, whenever these functions are being held, then there is a common social function is there, which is called Payalika. That is, the women are asked to put, there will be one part, number of parts, 5-6 parts, in that they feel sad and pour water and make it wet. And in the previous day, they soak this, all these cereals, that is, all the green gram and all these grams, and some other corn, and they are all soaked, danya, all these things are. spoke, and then the ladies will probably it is put that in those things, and it will after 1 or 2 days it will sprout actually. Then after when they sprout, after, when the function is over, then it is thrown into the river actually. Pali, I think many of you may be knowing, right? Pali has a culture. For that, there is one mantra they used to chant, the Pandit used to chant, and the ladies used to put, do this. They used to put that seeds into those, this, into that earth. That earth. Moisture earth will be there, and then they put these things. So that mantra is called Oshadhi Sukta. There are 16 mantras are there in that Oshadhi Sukta. I don't know now by heart. I don't know it by heart. So I did just to give you an idea of that. 16 mantras are there. It is usually chanted. When this is chanted, these ladies, they will be talking something and then they will put it and they will grow. Later on, I just one day, I happened to see this mantra and then some, what is this Oshadhi Sukta or something like that. Certain interesting things I found out actually. So Oshadaya Sambadanti, like that it starts. They say that these plants, they speak about these plants. Oshadhi does not mean medicinal plants, Oshadhi means all plants. In Sanskrit, Oshadhi means all plants. It can also mean this medicinal plant. So now what are you? We consume food. So that food actually takes care of our appetite. Your appetite is a disease, considered as a disease of food. Chudvyadishya chikrityadam, chuta and pipasa are considered as one type of disease for the body. Chuta. So this food is a medicine for this disease actually. And drinking water is to cure that pipasa dukkha. Pipasa means padavicha. Desire to, you feel thirsty. The hunger and thirst are considered as common diseases like corona. It should not go away. So you have to drink something. So this is a vyadi. For that, the food is a disease. It's a medicine actually. So we have to take food as if we are taking a pill like a bit. To the extent required only, we should take food. So then he says, then other diseases are also there. Suppose you have got headache. Headache, some medicine you consume. So there is some other disease. There may be some disease in the eye, some disease in the ear. For all those diseases, we put the medicine into the mouth. So the mantra says, the moment I take, it speaks about the plants, the moment I take these plants, the leaves, the medicinal leaves, or the seeds, the moment I take this in my hand, the disease started trembling actually. Oh, this fellow will destroy me, this fellow will drive me out of it. The moment I take, the mantra says, the moment I take you in my hand, the disease started trembling. And then it says that, suppose if you have a pain in the ear, and you take the food, the medicine you take, put it in the mouth only, how the medicine, this, the leaf, the medicine or the, whichever leaf you consume, whichever plant you consume, in the powder form or in leafy form or in paste form, whichever form you can see, it is plant only. So the moment I take this Oshadhi in my hand and put it in my mouth, how that will, it will know that the pain is, the problem is there in the ear. You are putting it, the problem is here, but the medicine you are putting it into the mouth. How the medicine will know to go there and act? An interesting thing. The pain is here, and you take the medicine here, you put the medicine here in the mouth. So sometimes there is some problem. Throat, there is some problem. So then some arista they give. so that you swallow, it goes into the stomach. So the problem is in the throat, or problem is in the eye, or problem is in the nose. So how this will know? So they say like that. So suppose if there is a crusher in a house, very valuable things, they will not be kept in an unsafe place. They will be kept in the center of the house and protected very well. Safe room will be there. So if any robber wants to, if anyone wants to loot that, he has to come there. There won't be any entry. It is protected, well protected. So the thief has to find out a place where he can jump, where he can enter into. So the lavatories will be outside, or some other things will be outside. In the periphery of the house, there will be some weak places where he can break and enter. He break through and enter there. Suppose if you want to keep it in the center of the house, he cannot enter there. You will find that this window is weak. Through this window he will enter. And then he will search where the root lies. Likewise, you search this. So mantra meaning actually. What I am explaining to you is the meaning of the mantra. It is not easily visible, but it is there. So the Oshadi will enter through a point where it is easy for it to enter, where there is an opening so that it can enter. Like a thief jumps through the lavatory or some other opening, and then he keeps searching where the loot lies, and then he goes there, and then he loots. Likewise, you enter through the mouth, and then search where the disease lies, and then you cure. These are the mantra meaning when you are doing this, throwing the seeds. These are the mantras. I have heard it later on, and then I found this. And then I referred to the commentary of the Sayanacharya's commentary only, based on Sayanacharya's commentary only, and whatever I am now saying, not that it will not be easily, we cannot understand this, because we don't think it is like this. The words are clear, the meaning is clear, but we can't understand this unless somebody explains it. So Sayanacharya has explained this way. So what's the importance of all the plant like this? Similarly, the animals. So the animal kingdom, the plant kingdom, and the human, all these things have, if one has to be safe, the other has to be safe. Sabno devi abhishtaye tachayora vrimahe gasum yajnaya gasum yajnapatiye devi swastirastunaha स्वस्थ्यर्माषेभ्य ऊर्धुजुगा शनो अस्तुपदे तचतुष्पदे ओम शांति 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 शनो अस्तुपदे ऊर्धुजुगा ऊर्धुजुगा मीन ऊर्धुजुगा लेट द प्लांट लाइफ बी रिच लेट द ट्रीज एंड प्लांट्स grow rich here. All the trees and plants, let there be rich growth of all these things. Let all the bipeds be happy. Bipeds does not mean humans. Bipeds mean cattle. Bipeds means wild animals. Bipeds means wild animals according to the weather. The cattle are Chaturpada. The cow, the goat, the elephants, they are all quadrupeds. And the lion, the tiger, all the wild animals are considered as bipeds in the Shastra. Because human is separate. The tiger, its hind legs are legs, and the front leg they will use like our hand. They will catch like this, they will tear like this. Only thing is they are horizontal beings, they are vertical beings. So their hand is down. The monkeys, they use the front legs. There is hands actually, they are not legs. You say it is legs, but they are not legs, it is hands. They pick this. They cannot do it with the hind legs. So when a tiger, they catch hold of its prey like this, and it will walk like this, holding on the hand. So that the bipeds be safe here. Then the quadrupeds be safe here. And when the bipeds mean the other thing, you should not think like that, because later on there are other stories where it explains. There are other stories which makes it very clear also. There is one story in the Srimad Bhagavat. In that, it's a very interesting story. There was one person, and name is not important, so I'm not mentioning you that. So Brahma told him, there you have good progeny. So he had, the story is like that, he had 10,000 children. So he said, all of you do the tapasya and may you all have progeny, he said. So they all went for tapasya. They did tapasya for quite a long period, very long period, and thousands of years. Stories like that. So when they had vision of God, then they wanted to come back. When they opened their eyes, they found that everywhere there is tall trees, thick forest. They could not even make out the direction. Sunlight doesn't fall there, whether it is day or night, they could not know. It was so dark, pitch dark. The trees are so thickly grown. So they began angry. So they started burning all the trees. They started burning all the trees. They created fire after that yoga siddhi and started burning the trees. And Brahma came. Brahma comes and tells an interesting story. My dear children, what are you doing? Stop it. I have created three things here. The quadrupeds, which have no hands, which have only legs, which have no hands. And then I have created those with hands. Those who have no legs, those who have legs, those who have hands. Three things I have created. I have created certain things which have no legs. What are those things which have no legs? Trees and grass. Trees, grass. Trees, what? Trees have no legs.
Fish.
Fish. Those very things. Yes. The grass is there. Yes, it has no leg. The tree has no leg. If you go and cut that, it cannot run actually. Suppose somebody is trying to hit you, you can run. The tree cannot run. So he has created grass, trees without legs, so that the quadrupeds, those who have got the cow and other cattle, they can come and eat that. Here in this world, everything is food. And everything is a meter also. Everything is food. And it's food for somebody else. So everything is a food here. And everyone is a meter also. Everything is meter also. So I have created grass, plants and all these things. They have no legs. So they cannot run. So the quadrupeds, those who have got legs, when they come, they eat these things. And these quadrupeds are food for the bipeds. They are the food for the cattle, the deer, the mammals, all this cow, goat, all other quadrupeds are food for those wild animals. The wild animals only kill them. Wild animals does not kill the wild animals and eat. They kill only these people. So there is a food cycle is there. Those who have no leg, they form the food for those who have got legs. And those who have got legs, they form the food for those who have got hands. That is wild animals. So if you cut one thing here, then the entire thing will collapse actually, because there is a link. So if the plant life is not there, then the cattle life will not be there. If the cattle are not there, the wild animals will not be there. So if you eliminate one, automatically you are, it amounts to eliminating everything here. Then he tells the advisor to stop that. And then the story is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. It is actually taken from the Vedas. So why I say this? Because everything here, whatever they see here, the presence of God has to be felt in everything here, because everything is the creation of God. It is His, and Swami Vivekananda says, the word creation is not used in our scriptures. It is manifestation. God has manifested Himself. God has become all these things. Whether it is plant or animal or human, devatas, or there are different grades. Everything is a manifestation of God here. He has become many. So to behold God in everything, whatever we see, let us behold Thee in all these names and forms. That's what Swami Sivananda Maharaj says in his universal prayer. That Thy name be ever on other lips. Let us behold Thee in all these names and forms. So Pujya Bapa did this too. His tongue was always engaged in repeating the name of God. Let Thy name be ever on our lips. He lived that. And let us behold Thee in all these names and forms. Whatever be the name, whatever be the form, that is nothing other than the Supreme Reality. You can call it by Sri Ram or Sri Krishna or Supreme Reality, Ramman, whatever it is. So that was Papa's Sanya. That was my sharing this thing. May Papa bless us. So that we also behold that Supreme Reality in everything here. Hari Om Tatsat.
Swamiji, I have two questions, Swamiji.
Aparamatma. Om Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Today evening, we will have a special present program from 8:15 to 9:15. That means after the aarti. It will be here only. By Sri Raghavendra and party. All are requested to kindly take advantage of this wonderful opportunity. Tomorrow, you make a mention of time. Tomorrow, 4 o'clock to
4 o'clock to 5 o'clock, morning 10:30 to morning. Hari Om.
You have to mention about something about him.
Tomorrow, today evening, Sri Prahladji Tipaniya is coming from Indore. He is also known as Kabir of present day because he lives Kabir Vani, that is his life. along with Swamiji, we were lucky to see his documentary, Had and Had, where they go in search of Kabir's Ram. So we were all very touched by that. So we are, this time he agreed to come here. So today evening he is reaching. Tomorrow morning, 10:30 to 11:30 at Bhajan Hall, we are going to have his bhajan in satsang. Similarly, in the evening, 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock, tomorrow evening, we will be having his bhajan satsang on Kabir again tomorrow afternoon.
Tomorrow evening, we will announce it tomorrow.
Tomorrow evening's, any special bhajan is there? Inform you tomorrow.
And on 27th December is a very auspicious occasion for all of us to remember, but for which we would not have been sitting here in the Vyavaharic sense. So God arranges everything in His own way. In the Vyavaharic sense, He prompted Vittal Rao to take the leap on 27th December 1922. So we are prompted to observe this 1 year, so that we'll get started on 27th. And Pujya Swamiji will initiate the steps. So we will have that program from 9 to 12. Day after tomorrow, 9 to 12. There will be prayer, there will be bhajan, there will be ashirvajan by Pujya Swamiji. And the, with that, you know, we set ourselves in a different mode. But for the next 1 year, we will all pray intensely to the indwelling reality to put us on the in-depth study of inquest of God as a part of our homage to Parampooja Papa, for all that He has facilitated us so far. So 27th. Evening also on that day?
Pranalaji.
I heard about Pranalaji. I don't know whether you have heard about him. He has gone deep into Kabir's life. We happened to go through a video where, not only in India, he went to Pakistan also, Kabir's devotees. And the revelations were so touching that we may feel that it is a personal aspect. Certainly not. As Papa used to say, the impersonal person. He has been trying to identify the impersonal person in Kabir. And then he has got a knack of presenting it, because it comes from the depth of his heart. Parabhakti. It is not merely a bhakti centered on a particular form, though the form is needed to express it. One of the devotees in Pakistan, we remember that word,
Kabir is mine. There is no compromise on Kabir.
Kabir is mine, not yours. No? And he says, Kabir is not there in any of the tangible forms. So that is why he is taking us from the personal aspect to the impersonal aspect. It is so touching. I have not heard his bhajans. Now, Papa has arranged it. He is coming all the way from Pune, no?
Indore.
Yeah. So tomorrow and day after tomorrow afternoon, we will have, and he is leaving.
7 o'clock Vishnu Bhajan evening.
And day after tomorrow's evening, there is a special bhajan by
7.
Vishnu Bhajan.
Starting 7.
Yeah. 7. 7 to 9, this small break for the Aarti, that's all. So all these programs, you know, we will not take it as a program. Everything is a Philip, is a push of our moving towards the in-depth study of inquest of God. It should not be lost sight of, please. Every one of us has to revisit the text, reread, and try to see what is there in between the lines, and to what extent we as devotees or sadhakas while dealing with the challenges, commitments, duties, how far it helps us. This is the purpose of this sannyasattva, swadhyay, sentinel. Every week from June, from January 1st to every Sunday, na?
Every
Sunday, yeah. Every Sunday from January, every Sunday, there will be a 10 minutes
video
on some aspects called out or dug out or plumbed through the inquest of the heart. It is not the final, so everyone has to do the digging, plumbing, manana, and see for himself or herself what is the practical hints Papa is giving us to make our lives more and more enriched, and it ultimately should give a push to move towards Him. Move towards Him means it is not that we are moving towards Him. He makes us aware of His perfect presence. He gives us first a glimpse and then He makes us aware of His presence. So this is what is aimed at for the entire year. We pray to Him who has given this strong prompting in all our minds, connecting with Papa's sannyas period, centenary period. Ultimately, all of us are on a special mission, special journey, an inward journey, in-depth study. So that is what is going to be launched on Sunday by Param Pooja Swami. At this age, Swamiji has come all the way from Rishikesh. The saints have got their own way of representing it. Each one is unique. Each one has delved deep into it. And each one is bringing out and placing it before us. All from all these, just like cows go to the grazing yard, they eat everything. No, they not eat. They swallow everything. Then comes back and sits and do the mastication. And what is required will be absorbed or assimilated. What is not needed will be passed out. So we are all given this wonderful privileges. So we will try to gather as much as possible and do the manana by ourselves and try to take the maximum advantage of it. Hari Om. Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Swamiji was mentioning about his visit to Ayodhya. We request all of you to go there in batches, spend some time on each board. That is the one really conveys something about the connectivity. You know? He is there in all forms, which Swamiji was telling now. But at least we will make a beginning. That one with which we eat, that one with which we drink, that one with which we breathe. That one with which, you know, we vitalize our life, the sun. And that one with which, on which we are standing, in which we are moving, you know, the space, the earth. We get some connection there at the intellectual level. That will enable us to slowly go within. When we take a mouthful of food, the photo will come. So kindly do visit, spend some time there. If all of you go there in one group, it will be difficult. So that is why yesterday we requested going 20 or 25 groups. Morning 10 to
12
and evening 3 to 4. Eh?
3 to 4.
So if you go there in 20, 25 numbers, you will be able to spend some time. There are about 10 boats. And you can see also, not merely boats. There are medicinal plants, fruit plants, vegetables, pulses, grains, different varieties are there. And the board, you know, board will be instrumental in making us to think about it. how to get myself connected to the Almighty Lord of the Universe, who has facilitated everything for us. I want protein, I want carbohydrate, I want vitamin, so many things, you know, in so many forms he is placing before us. When he gave us a body, he wanted this body to exist, you know. So what, there are so many things that are needed for this body. That also he has provided through various ones. When he falls sick, he provides us the medicine. So like that, we get some connectivity that may help us. And to really actualize Papa's words, behold divinity in every aspect of this world lila. Verily it is he who is at play in our beings and creatures. Hari Om. Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram 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 Om
Minute.